not everybody, just two maximum. There will be a third official there to keep you all in check. I'm sure if you smile at them. Okay. Goalkeepers. All teams must have two goalkeepers, minimum, for this tournament. Both must be on the matchday squad. If one is injured or is serving a ban, you can just have one. Okay? However, if that goalkeeper is sent off or is injured, we revert to rule 4.1.2 of the laws of the game, where an outfield player can go and goal and he can wear his prosthesis. He must tuck his arm inside the shirt like the goalkeeper would, but the prosthesis must be safe. Yeah? No metal, nothing, yeah? All has to be padded out properly and safe. Okay? So have a little think if something happens. Make sure you know what you're gonna do. Okay. There is a disciplinary committee in place, and they will deal with the red card and yellow card offences. Okay? This format is for the competition. If you receive a red card, it will be a minimum of a one-match ban. If, however, in extreme circumstances, it could go to six. So you can imagine what you have to do to get a six-match ban, yeah? So, very, very extreme cases. Okay. Yellow cards. In the group stages, and it will also be for the quarter-final stage. So the first four games that the teams will play, if a player receives two yellow cards, so he has a caution in game one, and he has a caution in game four, okay? He will miss the next game. Okay? After the quarter-final stage, it goes back to zero, okay? So if you get a caution in game one and you get a game for caution in the quarterfinal, you will miss the semi-final. Okay? If you get a caution in the final, you will play in the final because you go back to zero. Okay? Yeah? Harsh, I know, but it's all about football. Okay? The referees will be appointed to all the games, and no referee will referee a game involving his own nation. Very, very important. Okay? Or a game that will be directly crucial for his country. So once we start getting to quarterfinal, semi-final stage, if they're playing them and they're going to play them, then they won't do. They will be independent officials. We have six officials from Turkey, we have two officials from Poland, we have one from England, one from Ireland, one from France, and one from Germany. Okay, so we have six officials. Okay. Right, there is also a general committee that will deal with any other matters. Okay, it's a technical committee that consists of President of the Turkish Federation, Mateus, President of IAAF. It will involve myself. It will involve Manuel Schmidt from Germany, the referee, and it will involve Gerard Behan from Ireland. If anything comes to that committee and it directly involves somebody from one of them countries, they will not have any impact and will not be in that group. So everything will be impartial. Okay? For those lucky enough, a gold medal will be awarded for the winners of the competition. They'll be given to all the players and the staff. Okay? Runners up will receive silver medals to all the players and the staff. Third place bronze, and that will also be for the players and the staff. There will be other awards. Best player of the championship. Three officials will pick a player per game, and each manager will pick a man of the match for the opposition. And come the end of the tournament, the player with the most votes will win. Same again, best goalkeeper for the championship. Each manager at the end of the competition will have a vote on this. Fair play, team of the championships, will work on the discipline process. That will be your conduct during the game, your conduct of your bench, yeah? So managers, staff, substitutes, everybody. Okay? And that's how that one will work. Okay. Going into the games, to make it easy for everybody, each team, as you know, is allowed one timeout per half. Okay? You can only take your timeout when the ball is dead and you are in control of the ball. So we're talking corner, it's a goal kick, it's a kick kick, it's a free kick. Okay? The easiest thing to do, because of obviously we have referees from six different countries and not everybody speaks the same language, each team, so the home team will be given home with the tee on. The away team will be given away with the tee on. And you will hand that to the third official. Okay? When you are in control of the ball, the third official will signal the timeout. The timeout will last 1 minute. Your players must stay on the field of play. Okay? So not going into the dugout, they must stay on the pitch. If you give this to the third official and you decide, no, I don't want it no more, you take it back. Okay? So if players going on and on and on and you decide, no, I don't want it no more, you can take it back. Okay? One timeout per team, per half. Once we get into the nitty gritty and we start going into the stages where we will have semi-finals, during extra time, each team will get an additional one timeout per half. Okay? Use it wisely. Yeah? What I would suggest, I'm not telling you what to do, but remember, you can only use it when you have possession of the ball. But the later you use it, if the ball's still in play and you don't get it, you're going to miss out. As you can see, this is the pitch. 6 meter rule will apply. So on free kicks, kick-ins, all 6 meters. Okay? If a penalty is awarded, it is 8 meters and on the edge of the area. Because it is on the edge of the area, it's classed as being inside the penalty area, and that is where the penalty spot will be. This will be the size of the pitch. It will be 60 metres long and it will be 40 metres wide. Your goal area is 8 metres and has a width of 10 metres. Remember, your goalkeeper must stay within that area. Okay? He will run the risk of being guarded if he comes out, depending on what he does. Remember, we're not silly. We know that we have momentum and one thing, you know, there's times where everybody looks and sometimes you come out the area. Okay, that's fine, yeah? We do not want people purposely coming out the area. Yeah? The technical areas will be here and here. When we go out to the pitches later, you will see the bench is here and here. But the technical area will come to here. There's about a 2 meter difference from here to the edge of your technical area. Okay, because the bench is that far back. Okay, so you've got plenty of room. Okay. Perfect, that looks like I'm done.
No, I'm just going to go for
a couple.
So, no, just a
there is a procedure for. Right, remember, all the games have been sorted, all the times have been sorted. We must run to time. If you have a game that kicks off at 12:30, that game must kick off at that time. Okay? I personally would advise that any of the teams staying in the hotel, you give as much time as possible to get here. You come today, you know how long it takes. Remember, traffic, it could take twice the length of time. There is, as Simon will discuss later, there are training pitches, well, not so much training pitch, more of a warm-up pitch for before the game. Remember, we must start on time. The referees will walk out the two teams. Okay, you will all walk out from the changing rooms together for the start of the match. Okay? When we go on the pitch, well, obviously we have a home team and a away team, we will line up. We will do the national anthems. Okay? After the national anthems and we do the fair play handshake, it is the home team that will start the handshake. Okay? The reason for this, it is because the home team is welcoming the away team. That is the reason for this. Okay, so if normally if you're at home, this is the procedure that you would take.
Okay. Silly stuff, but the rest of the world.
Yeah?
Are we returning to the dressing rooms after our warm up to go out with the ref? So are we going out
from
the
back? You will not be going from the warm up pitch straight to the match pitch.
We're going from the warm up pitch, led by the ref to the match pitch.
Once afterwards, Simon will explain, but we're going to go show you the change room, show you the warm up pitch, so we have an idea of how long it's going to take and everything else. But if everybody walks out together, we're not going to have one team standing there waiting for the other team to come and vice versa.
That's fine, yep.
Okay. If it was closer, we would just stand in the tunnel and walk straight out. Yeah. Any other questions on that?
Not on that exactly, but during the timeout, the staff allowed to enter the pitch to give treatment to a player or to give some advice?
Well, if you think about it, this is the edge of the pitch. Yeah, a timeout, you can stand there, directly in front of them. Just don't come on the edge.
Yeah, I mean for to treat the player, for the medical staff.
Treat the player.
I need permission from a referee.
I would suggest a bit of common sense.
Okay.
Okay.
I got another question. It's about the color of the goalkeeper's jersey.
Yes.
It differs from the squad, from the players on the pitch. And what happens if it looks similar to the opponent's color?
Then we will have to change.
So you will check before the game. You will check before the game?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, at some point today, I should have all the colours of every team that's playing in this tournament. Okay? As a bit of a... I'll tell you the colours the referees will be in. The referees will either be in a crimson colour, which is like purple. They will either be in a blue, a light bluish colour, or they will be in yellow. So...
Yeah, I know. Our keepers have... light orange and red. And
yeah, what we'll do is in a minute before we go out,
okay.
You're actually going to go through so every team is clear now what colour kit they'll be wearing so that there's no discrepancies on
okay.
That.
Just fine.
And that way you can work out your wash schedule and stuff like that. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Anything else though?
Yeah.
The goalkeepers have to put their arm in the shirt?
Goalkeeper's arm has to be inside the shirt, yeah. And the sleeve tucked inside.
Okay. Because if it's in the shirt, I can do this, and you don't see it. If I do out of the shirt, I can do this. And if it is contact, I get a red or a yellow card. So
this is the reason for this. This is a directive from the World Anti Football Federation, and we have to apply by what they say.
Okay. Perfect.
Whether we agree with it or not, at Congress, they all sat in the room, and this is what they decided.
Okay. Thank you.
A very important one, guys. Within the rules, crutches. The bottom of your crutches must match the colour of your team socks. Does everybody understand that? Yeah? If your socks are of two colours, the most prominent colour you have. Yes? Okay? Does every team have tape? If not, I would advise that you let somebody know very, very quickly. I know there's a village not too far away, and I'm sure that somebody would be able to get in. Yes.
One question. If two teams have the same colour of socks,
then the away team will change.
If they have only one colour of socks?
Well, team is supposed to have two change of kit.
Of shirt, okay, but socks will have only one colour. Red.
So two changes of kit. Kit must be completely different. I would advise if you only have one pair of socks, yeah? I would advise that if that is the case, then whoever you play, if they're in the same colour sock, that will be sorted.
You're gone. You're gone.
Yeah? I think there's a flight to France in 20 minutes, yeah? Why people sock? Then we need to sort it out. However, in the tournament regulations, it says teams are supposed to have two.
We have two kits.
Oh, you have two tops. That's not kit. Kit, full kit. Not tops. Tops, kit. Yeah? So, okay, we won't keep you much longer now. So just to confirm, you all understand, you will only have the dressing room for 1.5 hours, okay? You will have it before. So if you're, for instance, tomorrow Spain and Georgia, you're playing at 11 o'clock. At 9:30, the dressing room is yours, okay? But at 12:30, you must be gone from that dressing room, yeah? Yeah. So that gives the next team, who's playing at 2:00, 1.5 hours for the use of that dressing room. Does it understand?
No. 1.5 hours included the match time?
No, because there's four dressing rooms.
Okay.
There's two for pitch two,
yes.
And there's two for pitch four.
Yes.
Okay, so what we don't, what we're trying to avoid is a team doesn't come to the dressing room.
Best way to describe it is, prior to the game, you have the dressing room for 1.5 hours. You will go out and play your game. Once you finish your game and you come back in, you will roughly have about 30 minutes to vacate the changing rooms before the next team comes in.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
That he's going to be strict by this.
Yes.
Because you cannot have a team who's due to go out, they have to go up to the training pitch, warm up, come back, and then go back out. So it has to be, okay?
Okay.
And again, just to confirm, it is your responsibility as the team manager, if you're staying in the hotel, to liaise with your interpreter of what time you want that bus. Okay. If a team is 15 minutes late appearing on the pitch, you're gone. The game is void. You forfeit the game. Okay. And we have to have that 15 minutes. Because we have to remember as well, Some of these games are going live, okay? So they have to start on time. There can be no delay in starting the game. Is there any questions on that?
The main problem with the changing room facilities that we have is obviously we only have four, and then between each game, there's an hour and a half gap. So one team on that one, once that kicks off, 90 minutes later, the next game will start on that pitch. An hour and a half later, that it's the schedule is very, very, very tight. Okay.
So, one thing on the opening ceremony. What we're going to do soon is we're going to go through the team colours and we're just going to go through all the matches. So, as coaches, you can write down exactly, you know now what kind of kit you'll be playing in, and we'll make sure there's no clash now. Just to jump forward, on the opening ceremony, we're asking, okay, that all players come to the pitch for the opening ceremony on crutches, not with prosthetics, okay? It's going to be live streamed live. We don't want any confusion. Our sport is very visual, so amputee players on crutches, and obviously goalkeepers, you haven't got a spare arm anyway. Yeah? We're all clear with that for the opening ceremony. All players will be on their crutches. Yeah? So do you want to go through the... Let's go through the colours. Okay, so for the first game, okay, just bear with us now and we'll get through this quickly now. So Turkey and Germany. Okay? Turkey, you're being red, yes?
Red.
Germany, what colours are you wearing?
We're wearing blue.
Blue.
But the goalkeeper, we have to look for.
What colour is your goalkeeper's kit?
Green.
And your keeper's kit?
Red.
That's okay, right. Green and red. Okay, Poland and France.
Blue, white, red.
France, here, hold on, quick. Your whistle is on. France.
Blue, white, red.
Right, blue. Poland? Red.
Red.
White shirt, red shirt, and white.
So white, red. Italy, Belgium.
White.
Blue, white, blue. You got that, Ian? Blue, white, blue.
Juste les chaussettes, savoir à quelle couleur vous jouez. Rouge aussi. Et vous avez qu'un jeu aussi. Vous avez qu'un jeu de chaussettes. Vous avez que la couleur rouge en chaussettes.
Non,
rouge.
C'est
black. Et vous avez noir aussi. Parce
que nous, on a que... Belgium, what are you playing in?
Red, black, red.
Red, black, red. No clashes so far. England, Greece.
Red. Outfield up and then goalkeepers with green, black, green.
Greece.
Blue.
Goalkeeper.
Light green and black.
We could change our keeper card,
Russia, Ireland. Russia.
Red.
Red. And goalkeeper?
Yellow.
Goalkeeper. Ireland?
Green, white, green.
And goalkeeper?
Black.
Okay. For the games on the 4th, Spain v Germany. Spain? Red. And goalkeeper?
Black.
And Germany?
White, black, black.
White, white, black.
White, black, black.
White, black.
And your goalkeeper?
Red.
You've got to put him in a different kit.
A totally different kit for the players?
For the goalkeeper.
Where we have orange alternative.
Orange. Okay, you need to clarify the two teams there. Spain and Germany, you need to clarify with the referees. Will you just bring the goalkeeper's kits just to confirm with Ian, just to show them so there's no problems, all right? Russia, Greece. Russia, Greece. When you play Greece on the 4th, what are you wearing?
Another kit.
Yeah, and what are you wearing on the day? On the 4th and the 10th, when you play Greece, what are you wearing?
Red, red, red.
Red, red, red. And the goalkeeper?
The same, yellow.
Yellow. And Greece?
Blue, four. Blue, blue, blue.
Blue, blue, blue. And goalkeeper?
Black, green, and black.
Black, green, and black. Okay, Italy, France?
Red.
Italy first, because they have gold. Italy?
White.
All white?
Oh, I'm sorry. With French, blue, white.
Blue, same. White, and blue.
And red, white, and
white.
Red.
Goalkeeper for Italy?
Black.
Black. And goalkeeper for
yellow.
France?
Yellow.
Yellow.
Yellow. Okay, brilliant. Poland v Belgium?
Red, white, red.
Red, white, red. And goalkeeper?
Green.
Green. And Belgium?
Black.
Black, 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 and blue.
England v Ireland?
Light blue, light blue, light blue.
Light blue, light blue, light blue.
Keeper up here, yellow, black, yellow.
And?
White, green, white.
White, green, white, and?
Goalkeeper red.
And goalkeeper red. Turkey v Georgia.
Yes.
All white. And goalkeeper? And Georgia? Red? All red? And goalkeeper? White, blue?
Light blue.
Light blue, you
said. Light blue, yeah.
Okay, so we move on to the 5th of the 10th. And France, Belgium?
Blue.
White, blue, white, red.
Blue, white, red. And goalkeeper?
Black.
Black.
Black. And Belgium?
Red, black, red.
Red.
And you will see for the goalkeeper, normally we have a black.
Yeah, we have to change the socks. The socks are the same.
Okay, the socks are the same. We take the black sock. Okay.
Black.
Red, black, black. Yes.
So red, black.
Black, black.
And the goalkeeper?
We have a normally black, but it's the same of France, so we will change.
We can change if you want.
In blue or.
Black, yeah.
But you play in blue, I think.
No, the goalkeeper is black or
no,
yellow.
No, but the field player.
Against you, yeah, blue.
Blue, okay. Blue. We will see if we the golden goalkeeper to do. We will manage it with
that. Okay, so before the game. Before the game, just confirm with the referee and the pallets, will you? Okay, and you'll have a spare one there anyway. Okay, Ireland v Greece. Ireland are at home.
Grey, grey, grey.
Grey, grey, grey. And goalkeeper?
Black.
Black.
Hold on, I'm going to work with it. I'll be black where the red with the grey one.
Red, yeah, no, sorry, yeah, red. Belgium? No, sorry. Greece?
Red, black, red.
Blue, blue, blue. And goalkeeper?
Black, green.
Germany, Georgia. Germany is at home.
Blue. Goalkeeper red.
Goalkeeper red. Georgia. Black, red. Black, red, socks. And the goalkeeper? Blue. You can't wear the same thing as the goalkeeper colour as the goalkeeper. Orange.
As long as it's different from red.
Yeah, as long as it stands out from the red, it has to be separate. Poland's home.
White, red, white.
Right. And goalkeeper?
Black.
Black. Italy?
We have a white, a blue and white.
Can't be. You have a choice.
I must change the second game.
Okay, now, Italy, what's the second game? Italy, France, just go through those kits again that you put down for Italy, Italy, France.
We're playing red, white, red.
Yeah.
But you can change it.
Okay,
and then you
play with the white, blue, white.
Second. White, blue, white. So, yes, we've got to change it. So, against Poland, then you're aware. Blue. Then the goalkeeper? Black. Okay, Russia, England.
White, blue, red.
Is that going to clash with you?
We can go Royal Blue. Sweat. What colours are sharp?
And the goalkeeper?
Yellow as well.
Yellow as well.
What have we gone for?
Red.
Red. Right, so if we go royal blue full kit, that class. Royal blue full kit, that'll be alright. Yeah, we'll
keeper.
Go royal blue and then pink goalie, so pink, flat, pink.
Okay, and the last game will be Turkey, Spain. White, 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 Red. Let them go red, red, red. Is that okay for you to do that, yeah? Because they're the police to charge. Okay. You got it? Red, red. Red, red, red. Yeah. And goalkeeper?
Black.
Hopefully you've all made a number of these colours now as well, so there's loads of problems. Sorry.
What about our
goalkeeper
during the match?
What did you give us?
Maybe black.
Right, on your first match is 1-2
and the third match. Why is there
black
and black?
What are you wearing? Goalkeeper.
Black.
We're playing yellow, the goalkeeper.
Yeah, look, I said to all the teams that they've asked for this reference. Look, what the games you're into the hand. Right, that's it for the round. Yes, sorry?
You didn't ask for the second game of Spain.
Spain, Germany, we did, didn't we? Okay.
Spain, Germany.
Spain and Germany, the second game. Alright, just write the Spain and Germany down.
Georgia.
Okay, we'll do that separately. I thought I asked them all. Spain and Germany then, which is on the 4th of the 10th.
Spain and Germany.
Did you say Spain and Georgia?
Game number 2. Germany they.
Okay, so we just clarify on the third then, the Spain and Georgia. So you're a home team, what are you wearing? Your first game?
White, white, white.
White, white, white. And the goalkeeper?
Black.
Black. And Georgia? That's the first game. Red, red, red. And your goalkeeper?
Blue.
Blue
and green.
Yeah. Is that all the games? We missed it. No? Everyone's happy?
They say they will play against Germany as well, but they didn't ask for Germany.
That's what they asked, that's all right. Spain, Germany, then. We must have just skipped you. You're a home team, so what are you wearing for that? That's your second game. White. And Germany?
Yeah, so we have to take blue, you ask me.
Yeah, I'll take.
Yeah, of course, so we have to take blue.
And the goalkeeper?
And the goalkeeper wears red.
Yes.
During the game, if I need to change the goalkeeper, can you go to the game? Have to wear the same sort of.
Yeah.
I have 15 goalkeepers. Green and
pink. Green has number one, pink has number 12.
Yeah, if you change the goalkeeper, you have to keep the same jersey.
What about the numbers?
Just have to stay the same. You have to stay the same. It all depends on the colour kit. It all depends on the difference, the colour of the kit compared to the other goalkeeper. You know what I'm saying? Again, before the match, clear it with the referee. Okay? We're going to make that before the match with the referee.
Guys, what's also very important is squad numbers. Okay? So if you are number seven, you are number seven for the whole tournament. Not number seven in game one, and in game two, number nine, and next game, number seven for the whole tournament.
How did you know that? Seven?
Whichever number you are given, that is your number for the whole tournament. You cannot do.
No, because we have
we borrowed a new from the Belgium
Federation,
and we have not the same numbers of our own. So the most numbers are the same, but some numbers are
7 or 17.
The two kits.
Yes.
The one is 7. The other is 17.
What you're going to have to do, we'll find out the form, and you're going to have to make sure that on that form you put both numbers on that form for that player. So in this kit, that is the number. And it will never change. If I am in this kit, that is the number. And if I'm in this kit, that is the number. Yeah?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Right, that's it now. Any questions? Any? No? I have one more question about the form. I have to fill it out before the game. Okay. For a reason, due to personal reasons, my team manager is going to arrive here on Friday. That means I have to sign as a team manager the first and second game. After to the third game, he has to sign the same person, or I can change it. Okay, thank you.
Because the person that brings it in to the referee will be signing it. It's signed in the changing room by the captain. And once it goes into the referee's room, they will confirm that that is your team and you.
Okay.
Is that it? Finished?
No.
Okay, we go and see the. Oh, if you have anything to say. Italy and Belgium.
Yes.
Yes.
What do you want to know?
Just the colour again. Red. Red, black, red.
Red,
black, red.
Italy playing in blue, white, blue.
Yes.
Yeah.
How will you know if a player? What's the notification process?
Player's banned.
When will you get told that the player's banned? That evening.
So will the team manager be notified? That,
yes.
And will the opposition be notified, or will it just be a place?
If a team player's banned, we notify the team manager.
Well, what'll happen is each night there'll be a referees committee meeting.
Yeah.
Okay? And they'll meet with if a player's banned, it will go to the disciplinary committee. Okay? Because he'll know if he's missing the next game because he's got the two yellows.
Yeah.
He will also know if he's got a red card that he's automatically. How long that ban is for will depend on the referees committee. And yeah, I know what you're saying, so it's not left too late in the evening before they tell you. So that's now to use the match.
If in the first four games, if one of your players has got two yellow cards, you know he's going to miss the next.
Yeah, no, sorry, I mean in terms of opposition, we do not know who's banned from opposite teams.
As a committee, we will know.
But opposition teams
will. The opposition team?
No, of course they will. Yeah. If a player's banned, it's banned. It's not a secret.
Yeah, but how will we be notified?
Is it just another team?
Yeah, another player. Yeah, got a player missing.
No, you don't
watch all the games.
No,
you watch all games.
Not this. It's not a secret, but it's not a massive announcement.
Right.
Go around and tell all the teams he's banned. But it's not a secret. If that makes sense.
If this player's banned, there's nothing to stop putting out a piece of paper and saying, okay, all bans going to put on that door or that door or whatever. Then everyone's in the same boat there. Everyone knows what's going on.
Thank
you. Yeah.
Just the other thing, what we have asked the referees to do is. There will be a man of the match, a player of the match, man of the match will be for every game, okay? And that will be something that we go down as a performance.
For the opening ceremony, do we have to wear our kit or can we go in?
You go, for the opening ceremony will be your... Your tracksuits, leisure. Oh, well, not tracksuits. Please don't wear tracksuits.
Okay.
Remember, this is visual, and this is going out on television, the live stream, and everything. We want it to be visual. We want it to see. So we would ask that players wear shorts, no legs, but it's up to Turkey and it's up to Germany if you want to come out in your playing kit or you're coming out in your, because time will be short for you. So it's up to you. Is Turkey going to be in their kit or? And Germany?
Yeah, we're entering our playing kit.
You're going to be in your?
Blue, blue, blue and our playing kit.
That's correct, yeah. Yes?
But goalkeeper, they are linked. The limb of 16 inch is too short to be bound. Is it necessary to bound the limb of goalkeeper? And it's very difficult to play with bound.
Belgium had a similar question before. What we suggest is, as long as that leg is inside the shirt,
yes,
and the sleeve is inside the shirt,
yes. But it's enough.
If we ask them, everybody will have a different answer, whether it's good, whether it's safe, whether it's not. Anything else?
So we're going to go on the... Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. I have a question from Polish TV. Which one is the answer?